Right, well, the second one I was going to ask was, again, with the internet, I read this a while ago, and I was hoping you could shed some light on it for us. I'd love it. At a recent a few years ago, at a BotCon convention where you were a guest, apparently you were asked a question about the business, and because there's some younger people here, I won't give the direct quote, but you gave a reply.
You all know the quote, I'm sure.
Wait, like, did they try to lynch you or something?
How many people know the quote, so I don't have to say it again? That's it?
About 12 inches, yeah.
Yes, okay. There's young people here. I'm afraid there's some young kids. Young kids in here? Some of the young kids here. They'll eventually get it, right, of course. Of course, the kids in Vancouver are much older than the kids in the U.S., right? Okay, what happened was somebody had asked me about, almost everybody wants to do voiceovers, okay? And I understand that. And as a teacher, I have a lot of people call me from all over the United States and a few from out of the United States asking me if they could be part of a class. And I say, what makes you assume that you're prepared, that you're ready yet? And they'll say, well, I have a great voice. I have a great voice. Well, what does that mean? I don't know what that means. Everybody has a sound. And if you're doing a character, there is no need for a great voice. It's just a voice. What you need is to be an actor. I said, saying you have a great voice is like having 12 inches for a guy. Unless you know how to use it, who cares? You know, everybody can pee. You got a Stradivarius? Great. Keep it in the closet unless you know how to play it. So the bottom line was that you have to prepare and you have to study acting and you have to take improv. We do a lot of improv. I mean, you know, some of these scripts, some are very good and some are very stilted. And you read something, you go, this doesn't read right, it feels wrong. Well, if you took the time to do that with every line that you felt uncomfortable with, you'd be there all day. So you improvise and you work around it. And unless they stop you and say, well, I want that line read exactly that way, you will. Then you just move on. And it becomes yours. It becomes a much more real character. And you feel, well, this is how the character would say this as opposed to this bifurcated dialogue that you sometimes run into. You won't know how to do that if you're not an actor. You just won't. And that answers your question. And there you got your 12 inches in, okay? Happy?
I would have preferred a handshake, sir.
Okay.